So in the last video, we have learned about how we can give web server access from the firewall and how we implement the policy and the NAT rules. So in this video, I will show you how we can configure destination NAT in the Palo Alto firewall. Like this is another way we can give access to a web server from the Palo Alto, and we can assign and we will assign destination NAT to web server that is 3735 router we have taken. We have configured in this router HTTP services. So now in this video, I will show you how we can enable destination NAT in the firewall. This is another way we can give access to web server. So let me show you in the firewall. So here in the last video, we have created one, it's a server one static NAT we have created. So in this NAT tool, the packet is source DMZ and it is destined to outside. Destination interface, we have taken 1/1, which is a firewall outside interface, and the server one local IP I have taken as a source address. Okay, which is 10.2.2.20, which is router IP I have taken, and here I have assigned source translation. That means 192.168.1.249 I have taken as a source translated IP, and which is outside global IP, select as bidirectional, so that anybody coming from the internet, anybody will be on the internet, he can easily access this web server. So next we will learn about how destination NAT will be implemented in Palo Alto firewall. So here I just disable this NAT rule, and next I will create another rule name as destination NAT server one. Okay, so this is important part, so we need to understand what we will give a source zone. So here, so in the source NAT, we have implemented a NAT rule from the server's perspective. Here we will implement another destination NAT rule from the user's perspective on internet. So user is on internet, so here we will take source zone outside zone. That means we are taking as a user perspective, which is outside zone. Destination zone is also the same, because destination IP we are taking here is 192.168.1.249, which is global IP address. So global IP address is residing outside, and we will take here outside zone. Okay, now this is an important point, we need to concentrate on it. So here destination address will be any interface. So we know destination outside interface is 1/1, so we will take 1/1, or we will take any interface. So here I will take any interface, no problem. And the source address, so here user on the internet is a source, right? I don't know what is the IP of that, so here we will take any. So here destination address, if we will think about destination zone, in the destination address we will take a global IP address, which is 192.168.1.249. so destination zone outside and destination IP will be the same. So here we will here we can see inside address and server one local IP object we have already taken. So here we will take another IP or another address object. So right now we will take a global server one. Okay, so global server one IP will be 192.168.1.249, and here we will, so original packet we have already mentioned here, and next we will go in translated packet. So here translated packet, we have to perform destination address translation. So here a source address translation we will take as none, and destination address translation we will take static IP, which is our server local IP, and we have already created a server one local IP address, object address. So here translated address will be the local server IP 10.2.2.20. Okay, so now we will do okay. Next we will commit here, and after that we will check our web server will be accessible or not from the internet. Okay, let's commit. Okay, commit successfully. So http 192.168.1.249 and enter. Okay, our web server is easily accessible from the internet. Admin, and the password is Cisco 123. Hit enter. Never. And come on, if we write show IP INT brief, it's working. Show IP route. So here 10.2.2.250, which is our DMZ. So here destination NAT rule, we can easily understand that a packet coming from the outside going towards outside, and we have taken destination interface any, and source address we have taken any. That means any user will get web server access. And here this destination address, we have taken a global service global server one, which is 192.168.1.249 IP, and service we have taken any. Source translation we are not taking here source translation, because we have done destination NAT here. So this destination translation, this part is very important here. So here a destination translation address server one local IP, which is 10.2.2.20, and whenever a user coming from the internet wants to get access, he just simply hit that IP address, global IP address we have taken, like 192.168.1.249, and he will easily accessible from the browser. So here if we come to security part, we have assigned a rule, which is webs access to server one. That means here the security policy rule will work on post NAT zone and pre NAT addresses. That means post NAT zone we have taken outside, which is a source, and a destination, which is here, is TMZ. Okay, and the pre NAT address we have taken 192.168.1.249. okay, and services HTTP. So here we can easily configure destination NAT rule in the firewall, and we can also assign source NAT, like that we have taken in the last video. So this is another way we can give access to users from the internet. So this is today's video, and I have recorded this video in English so that everybody will understand this video and will get benefited. So in the next video we will learn more about latest technologies and latest stuffs which we have not done yet. So if you really like my video, please hit the like button, and if you want more videos, more updates, then just subscribe my channel. So we'll meet you in the next session, in the next video. Till then, goodbye, and keep watching Being Proactive.